Hello and welcome to a new SolidSteel parametric for SolidWorks video. Today we are going to look at how to design a splice joint like this one. Of course, that's a lot of components with all the boltings and sheets. But with SolidSteel it almost doesn't matter if we design a small splice joint with a few components or such a big one here. Both is very quick and easy. In this steel frame for a plant design, I've left the joint between two profiles blank to show how the splice plates and the boltings are added. Let's just start with one of the smaller splice joints, and of course we'll use the tool of the same name for that. Basically, we first select the two faces that we want to join. We get a preview, which we can now define exactly in the settings area. I change the number of columns to 2 and rows to 4. The 4 means that 4 rows are added on both sides of the joint. Now I change the spacing of the holes relative to the edge of the tab. First top and bottom, then left and right. Here I set the vertical distance between the holes, and here the horizontal distance. I increase the thickness of the plate to 20 mm. To insert the bolting directly, we click on Assemble, which opens the part selection. As usual in SolidSteel, we can quickly and precisely define the screw connection, including the clamping length, and add it to the connection. This already looks good. We confirm and the first splice joint is added. On the opposite side, we add an identical one, here now in fast forward. Now let's move on to the large splice joint. The general adding of the plate is no different from the previous ones. Here of course there are more bolts. 4 columns and 4 rows, all with symmetrical spacing of 80 mm each. However, since this time we are placing a tab on both sides of the web, we don't add the bolting directly in this step and choose the option Create Holes Only with a diameter of 30 mm. If we had added the boltings during this step, the clamping length would have been calculated without taking the second plate on the back into account and would then have been too short. We will add bolting later with the manual bolting function. The second plate is added to the back in exactly the same way. You may wonder now if the holes have been added twice into the beam right now. Of course this does not happen. The software uses the extrude cut function for this, and SolidSteel recognizes that the holes are already present. We can also take a detailed look at the beam. We see our bore pattern, and if we take a look at the entries in the feature tree, we see that they are only present once. Okay, back in our assembly, we are now going to add the bolting with the manual boltings tool. Now we could of course select all individual holes up here, but with 32 of them, that would be too tedious for me. Instead we use the function select multiple and select these two faces one after the other. Oops, to zoom out awkwardly is not mandatory for this step. Well, by clicking Add, manual boltings now determines all through holes that are present in both surfaces. From here on, assembling the boltings works exactly as always via the part selection. To show another function, I now intentionally select the bolt diameter that is too large. If I now confirm this selection, we first get a preview as usual. But if we now want to edit finally, we get a warning and can cancel by clicking on No to correct this mistake. As you can see, the preview of the wrong bolts has also been removed. We'll do it once more, this time with a fitting size. Now everything works as intended. By the way, checking the bolts works not only for diameters that are too large, but also for diameters that are too small. Tolerances for this can be set centrally in the SolidSteel system settings. Here you can set the default hole diameter and the hole diameter tolerance to large, medium or small. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Of course, feel free to hit like or subscribe to the channel. We are really excited about that. For more information, check out our website, and if you have any questions, just get in touch. See you next time.